Today, I'm going to discuss performance versus behavior. Let's start by defining both of those terms. Performance is the level of efficiency and effectiveness to which somebody accomplishes their assigned task. High performance often results in high ROI. Behavior, on the other hand, is simply moral and ethical character. Behavior is trustworthiness. Behavior is someone's willingness to show up on time every day with a great attitude and do a great job. Now, ideally, you have high performance and high behavior. And that's easy. Reward that person, recognize that person, keep that person tasked, keep them challenged, and most importantly, keep them on your team. Low performance, low behavior is also easy. See you later. Then go to your HR department and ask how it was that somebody with low performance and low behavior was even hired. Where it becomes a bit more tricky is when you have a high-performing, low-behaving individual or a high-behaving, low-performing individual. Let's look at high-performance, low-behavior first. As stated earlier, a high-performing person is good for ROI. They're good at what they do, they're recognized as a subject matter expert, and you come to rely heavily on that high-performing person. That low behavior, on the other hand, can be a poison, it can be a cancer, and it can spread throughout your organization. What I have come to realize through my own experience is that when I have a high-performing, low-behaving individual, you gotta go. That low behavior is detrimental to the rest of the organization. There was one instance where I had a high-performing individual who had low behavior, and I kept that person on the team for a long time, longer than I should have. When I finally let that person go, others in the organization asked me, what took so long? What took me so long to cut that person loose? Okay, the last one, high behavior, low performance. Once again, behavior is moral and ethical character. People either come through the door with high moral and ethical character, or they don't. If they have it, you have something to work with. And a high-behaving, low-performing individual, it's the job of the leader and the remaining teammates to bring that performance up to the level that you expect. Or you can reduce the expectation. Positions are often created based on an individual's ability to perform. The summary is, if you have high performance and high behavior, you're in great shape. If you have low performance, low behavior, that's easy. If you have high performance, low behavior, that's easy. If you have high behavior, low performance, let's train that person and make them a valued member of the team. Thanks, and we'll see you next time.